Today, I will be embarking on some Illustrator digital line art inspired by the amazing work by Patrick Seymour. You can follow along and learn the technique as you watch. Welcome back to Satori Graphics. I hope you are doing great today. I have some Illustrator line art inspired by Patrick Seymour. This was suggested by a subscriber, and I was going to make a tutorial, but I simply don't have the time right now, so I made a speed up video instead. If you check out Patrick Seymour's work online, you will notice his unique and amazing style. It is mainly created by using lines and strokes in Illustrator along with gradients. It truly rocks. So I'm going to try and design something based around Majora's mask. I took an image of Majora's mask and locked it in Illustrator. You can make this style of digital line art by using a sketch you made yourself or based around an image online. I set a guide right down the middle because a lot of this artwork can be duplicated if it's symmetrical. I started with the eyes, as you can see. The trick is to think of lines making up everything, so the shapes, the textures, and the details all need to be lines. Here, I was using the duplicate option by holding down Alt and then clicking and dragging the same shape downwards. I then moved to the most tedious and most annoying part of this Illustrator digital line art design, making the spikes of Majora's mask. Like I said, I did want to make a tutorial, but I had very little time today. Remember, I'm a graphic designer first and foremost, and then I make 5 YouTube videos per week, and it can be tough keeping up with things. As a matter of fact, I have 2 logo designs running at the moment. So here is one spike and one eye more or less complete of the Majora's mask. This stroke style here is the way that you want to curve the lines. If you see Patrick Seymour's style, I'm pretty sure he used the same technique on his artwork. So continuing with the top part here, I wanted to make a sweeping stroke effect to make up the design, using the pen tool and the stroke effect as I have done beforehand. At this point, you could stop right here, as Patrick Seymour's work sometimes does only have white lines. The key is to have a dark background. This is where I start to add gradients to my design. I looked at the original image and tried to replicate the color by using the gradient tool. I set a gradient across multiple lines at one time. The design is really coming together now. Around the eyes, there are dark areas, but it's important to not go so dark that the design gets lost in the background. There was a lot of playing around with the gradient tool and the gradient sliders, and this probably took up the most time with this Illustrator digital art design. I spend a lot of time trying to get the gradients on point for these spikes. Next. So here's the final design. Now just to attach my satorigraphics signature. I'm really pleased with how this came out. What do you think? Does it replicate Patrick Seymour's style of line art? Let me know in the comment section below and be sure to subscribe and turn on your notifications if you haven't done already. Like and share this video if you can, and until next time, Design Future Today. Peace.